What's up, guys? This is Hot Diet 7 RCT bringing you another video for you guys. Today I wanted to do a special something related to some of the tools that I use for the videos for you guys, for the content and stuff for the channel. Now, for the longest time, I have been using most of the time OBS as my main recording, let's say, tool or software to do the videos and stuff like that. Now, recently, with a recent upgrade that I did to my computer on the graphics side, there was this little software, as you can see by, which is called AMD ReLive. I really don't know which one is the correct wording of that name. I'm going to call it from here on out ReLive, because it kind of makes more sense with the whole streaming and capturing and stuff like that, like, you know, reliving, whatever. I haven't checked it up. I'm lazy in that way, so sue me. The point is that I wanted to make this video because, I don't know, I just felt right that with all the goodness that I found in this software, which is right there included with the drivers as part of the software interface that has to do with everything, with the settings, with the graphics card and stuff like that. You have so many options, but I never felt kind of like compelled to want to do a video because, you know, it's just something that every day, you know, that you will find every day if you're an AMD card owner. So I didn't really think much of it, but for some weird reason, every time I would search on YouTube to get more info on this, as I started getting curious, I saw that there wasn't a lot of people doing videos on this. So I said, what the hell, you know, let's fill that gap if there's any at all, and kind of walk you through basically what you have to do to take advantage of this. Now, the reason number two or three would be the fact that this is a software. What makes it special is the fact that it takes so little of your resources. If you're kind of like in a resource budget, limited in terms of power of your computer, it's not, you know, powerful enough to run several things at the same time, which has been the bane of my existence for a long time, because as much as I've had enough power to run, let's say, games and stuff like that for you guys, when it comes down to the recording, capturing, you know, both gameplay and as I talk with you guys, there's always a trade-off. There's always something that has to go dial down, either the quality of the video or the quality of the game. What this software does is basically it gives you the option of recording in a different format, in a different using a different encoder, which is what they call that. Usually, for the longest time, we've been using without knowing an encoder, which is AVC, and AVC and a certain format or file format for it, which is H.264. That's the naming convention of the encoder. That's basically the standard. It has been the standard for the longest time, and that's what we usually record, especially if you want to record stuff like on MP4s to upload to YouTube, etc., etc. Now, what this one does is it takes another format, which is the HEVC. This one, both sides, NVIDIA and AMD have been working on it. NVIDIA has their own version, but since I have the AMD card, I'm going to be focusing on this one. And it does it, it's kind of like the next step. Instead of H.264 is 265, something along those lines. Basically, it's a higher quality, and it uses more of the GPU side of things instead of just hogging all the CPU power. And what that allows is, for example, in my case, I can take and do a video, capturing video and stuff like that, and capturing the game running at the same time without sacrificing as much power, because the CPU is not going to max out. The CPU is not going to be tied down by doing encoding of video and stuff like that, and it's going to share some of that load with the GPU. Now, in theory, it sounded really good, and I was a little skeptical of it. I did many tests to figure, you know, what was the trick, if there was still something underneath there that was gonna creep up or something like that. I'm happy to report that aside from not having like a lot of options in terms of, let's say, scenes and stuff like that, which I'm gonna talk later on, basically it works better for me than actually using OBS all the time now. I'm still not in a point where I'm going to be saying goodbye to OBS, because OBS has been very good to me in the sense that it's a free software. It's been developed like for years and years, and it still has the most options that you could ever want in when it comes to doing recordings and streaming and stuff like that. So let's go to the other screen so I can start showing you guys and walk you through it. Hope you guys enjoy it. Alright guys, so we're ready to roll with this here in the desktop view. I'm going to bring up or call up the Radeon settings from where we're going to do most of the stuff here anyways, is where you're going to see ReLive all the way up here. Basically it's standard stuff, because usually you come here if you have an AMD card. Come here mostly to go into gaming and set up your profiles for your games so they run the best way possible. If not, you want to go and mess up around with your display and the different features and pixel formats and stuff like that. If you like to tinker with this stuff, it is, you know, if you like to move things around or whatever, play around with the video. But as soon as you go into the ReLive section, I just hope I'm saying that right. ReLive, if I'm saying it wrong, you guys correct me, please don't be cruel. But anyways, to the point. The point is that once you're here in ReLive, you have a series of different options here in the top. All of these are very useful. In my case, the most that I got out of is recording and scene, because as you guys know, I use a lot of the scenes and stuff and overlays within OBS. Now, the best or the greatest part about this, there's some sections here like remote play and some Steam VR integration for those who are into that. And then of course you have the live streaming. However, live streaming is a thing that I have not used because let's say that the format, the encoding format that I want to use to take advantage, does not play well with Twitch, like most of the stuff. But there are other options here as well. You can connect to Facebook and different social media, YouTube, which is something that I'm going to be trying later on, because if I can stream from there and it plays well with the encoder, then I think I'm going to give it a shot. But later, I'll let you guys know how that goes once I try it out. But here is where basically all of the magic happens. This is the recording session, the recording section. This is the encoding type that I was talking about. I'm not going to mess too much with the settings because I am actually recording using this right now. It's live. It's recording. I'm going to bring up the overlay, which of course you get hotkeys that you can assign your keyboard to, so you can bring this up. But if you go here, or if I go here, you're going to see that it's right now it's recording. So I am not going to mess too much with the settings. I don't want to ruin this. So basically it gives you a lot of options, one which is the HEVC that I was talking about, and this is the standard that you usually record with, the AVC one. That one unfortunately uses a bit more, unless you have an option to change that. It uses most of the time, it uses the CPU and CPU alone to do this. Now you can create a recording profile and you can record at different, like different FPS. I have it recording to 30. It's more than enough to cover for this, but you can record at 60. Automatic channels, instant replay, which is another feature. I'm not gonna get into that. Instant GIF and instant game replay, which affects basically when you're playing a game. You can activate that, and what it does, it's going to record kind of like a TiVo used to do back in the day, and it's going to record a section of the recording is gonna go back in time and give you that, so you can like record a cool moment or whatever in your gameplay, and you know, I have fun with those kind of things. This is basically the setting that I have it. I'm recording at 40 mega right now, because 40 megabits right now is really good for recording in 4K. It's recommended to be to use between 35 and 50 for that, but I'm gonna stay right here in 40. Now, this area right here, let me open this a bit to make it easier on the eyes, hopefully. This right here is where I was able to set up a overlay image, and that's the only option that you have here, only one. If you use, for some reason, the simple mode, it has two modes. It has an advanced and a simple. I cannot change it, unfortunately, right now because I am recording. But when you change this to the advanced mode, what it does is it allows you to create some scenes. And these scenes, you have a limited amount of stuff that you can do. It's really good, and I did try it out. However, I got stuck in the chroma key part, because as you can see, I'm gonna move the mouse, you can see right here I'm using chroma key, so I can block out the green screen and stuff like that. And it's a really good thing to have, and I commend AMD for doing this. But for some reason, it works really well, and it, just by setting it in high, it just works perfectly, as you can see, you know, no mistakes, no correction, you know, bad stuff or whatever going on, it works fine. But when you change this into advanced mode, which you assume would have the feature as well, it doesn't have it, and it doesn't have anywhere for you to adjust it the way that you adjust it here. I wish I could have showed you guys. Another thing is, when it comes to the camera position, like the camera that I'm using right now, I had to download some information on resolution and positioning on screen and stuff like that, because this is not documented well enough. And if you go to the AMD site looking for information, you're gonna find a lack of information there too. Regarding what? Well, basically the positioning of the camera on the screen while you're gonna be recording. Now, you have, in order for me to do this, like if you notice a few videos back, you're gonna see that I had a camera on the gameplay, let's say for Warframe and for other videos that I did, you're gonna see that the position of the camera was lower, was actually lower, a little bit more to the side and smaller. That's because that was a size, a standard size that you would have to, you know, to place your camera, your webcam. I had, if you wanted a custom location, or you wanted to position it in a different place that wasn't top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right, you would have to mess around with these numbers until you find the perfect location. So I'm not too torn about it, because like I said, and I've said many times, I love to tweak with things, but it's a thing to consider if you're looking forward to something that's going to be like straight up press a button and it's going to be done. It's not there yet. I assume that given the importance that AMD has given to this software, this feature, hopefully it will be corrected in future updates. I'm looking forward to it, because to be honest, this is the only area, the area of the scene where this is lacking. But that is where the bad news ends, because that's about it. You know, you need to have a little bit of, yeah, be careful and test a lot, do a lot of recordings to see the positioning of the overlays and stuff like that. That is something that I had the time and I was willing to do, but a lot of people are not going to be willing to invest so much time or effort to just get something as simple as putting a webcam and an overlay onto your videos. Now, I know all of that sounded a little bit negative, but like I said, that it stops right there. You know, the negative part just stops right there. The rest is what makes me extremely happy, and is, of course, once you have all of this set up, and once you have the recording part set up with HEVC and and you set your bitrate, because this is what's going to allow you to set the quality that you want. And of course, the recording frames per second and all that stuff. You get all your, let's say your microphone. It will detect your devices if you're using webcams and mics and stuff like that. I have mine with my settings. You see, it shows a blue snowball here. It even gives you a feature to push to talk, you know, which I don't need at this time. Basically, once you have that, it's a matter of just setting a keyboard shortcut to bring up the overlay. Now, you can do this every time you put on a game. Right now, it has the option, aside from, you know, you have the settings here, you have the screenshot, you have everything that you need in order to tweak stuff before you go recording without having to bring up the Radeon settings. But you have everything right here within the overlay that you need to activate it, of course, from the settings. And you have to take a screenshot, and you go into settings. You can even deactivate microphone from here. Now, since I have it to record desktop for the purposes of this tutorial, you're not gonna have this in the way of your gameplay recordings or anything like that. This is not going to appear. It's appearing here because I'm recording desktop. There's the whole purpose of it. But when you're in the game and you're wanting to record from a section point on, you're gonna have all of this available to you, the cameras and positions and stuff like that, which you can change on the fly while you're recording, and turn off microphone and all that stuff. It's really, really good stuff. It's really nice to have these options from AMD. I'm really appreciative. I'm really happy that this is something that I didn't have to pay through the nose in order to use. So yeah, you know, two thumbs ups for AMD for doing this stuff. You made my life a lot easier, and thanks to them and this software, you guys are gonna be able to get a bit more quality videos out of me, because since I'm recording in this, using this encoder, using this let's say encoding type, I'm able to save some of that CPU power that I need for the game to run well while recording, because I have more than enough power to run the games, and I have more than enough power to run the videos. But if you're like me and have just one setup, one computer, if you have two computers, one for streaming and recording and one for gameplay, then this video is not for you. I'm more trying to appeal to those guys, average Joes just like me, that have limited resources to work with. This is fantastic. So I hope this was useful. If you have any questions regarding this or any other topic that you would like me to address, please leave a comment down below. Please like and subscribe as always. And thank you very much for being here. See you next time, guys. RCT out.